don't often have this opportunity, but Cann just made a rather onerous grammatical error. You don't say most gracious. I'm an English teacher. I never get to do that, because he never makes mistakes.
Fourth without the top.
Beehives.
People will never let him live that down. Anyway, this is the wonderful part of the evening where we recognize a writer who speaks to our passion, not just about Ireland, but about what is good and true and strong and real in the world. For several years now, and I still insist he's 12 years old, but he can't be, because he's done so much. But Colum has written such books over the last at least years, culminating with the brilliant accomplishment of Let the Great World Spin. I never think of that book, Colum, without our precious Frank McCourt. And when Colum, Frank is, was a very dear friend to Colum, to so many of us, and Colum asked him to write a blurb for the book, and Frank said, I'm really worried about Colum Cann now. He's gone and written the perfect novel. What's he going to do now? So it's wonderful that the world, certainly the Impact Literary Award, so many other, the National Book Award, have recognized the brilliance of that writing. And I like to think that Colum has come home tonight to receive the A.W.B. Vincent Ireland Fund Literary Award. It speaks to our history, it speaks to our precious Billy, it speaks to our very generous donor, Marion Davies Lewis, it speaks to the glue that holds us together, to use Father Mark Hederman's term. So Colum, you are carrying a lot of us with you. We're privileged to have you here. I'd like you to talk to us, and then we're going, it's not quite on the level of the Impact Award, but it's given with such love and appreciation. Colum Cann.